Hey guys, it's Christine with Gage Girl Training, and for this video I'm going to give you guys a high-level overview of what type of supplements are on the market and how to know if they are right for you. So let's get started. Alright guys, so there are so many sports nutrition supplements, and they are becoming more and more popular for the average person to start taking them. And I was recently having a conversation with a client who gave me a laundry list of supplements that she's on, and she's like, is there anything else I need to be on? And I think some people get a little like supplement happy, and they just kind of want to buy every product and be on everything. And I want to break down for you guys some of the major classes of supplements, give you guys some high level details and information about what those supplements are and whether or not those are right for you. So if you walk into any GNC vitamin shop, go to like a bodybuilding.com or any other supplement website, you will find that there are different categories of supplements. So there are protein supplements. Within protein supplements, there are supplements that are considered meal replacers. They have protein in them, but they also have a different category of breakdown as far as the amount of carbs and fat they have in them. If something's a true protein supplement, it's actually almost, it's very high in protein. It should be like over 80% protein to be considered like a pure protein supplement, because the reality is you can get your carbs and fat from other sources very cheap. Carbs are like the cheapest thing on the planet. Protein is not. And any of you guys who have been on this type of lifestyle for any amount of time know that protein is what makes the grocery bill so expensive. Shopping for deals is always super important. So protein is its own category. There are so many different types of protein, but protein is its own category. There's also another category called pre-workouts. There are intra-workouts. There are post-workouts. And there are fat burners. And there are weight gainers. Then there's also other things that are more performance-oriented. So if we can go through these one at a time, I think it'll really help enrich your understanding. All right, guys. So when it comes to sports nutrition supplements, I just wanted to preempt this with saying that owning a supplement company and being a formulator for a supplement company, like, I've been in product development and process development my entire life. So this is literally like speaking my language. Just makes me all happy inside, because this is just what I do. So first category, protein. Do you need protein supplements? Quick answer, no you don't. The only reason you would want to take a protein supplement is if you want a convenient and economical option to get your protein. People like to get their protein from real whole food, and that's totally cool. I like that. However, it can get expensive. If you're talking about cost per serving, like 4 ounces of salmon versus the equivalent amount of protein in a scoop of protein powder, we're talking like less than a dollar per serving, where 4 ounces of salmon, it can get pricey. And it's just easy. So the thing that you guys really need to know about a protein supplement, just because something is in a jar does not mean it's a true protein supplement. If something is a true protein supplement, it's going to have more than 80% protein in it. That means if you take the total serving size, you take the number of grams of protein in that product, divide it by the serving size of that product, and if that is 80% or higher, you have a good quality protein supplement. Like I was saying before, carbs and fat are cheap. Don't get products that already have them pre-formulated into them, because you can't take them out once they're already in. So get products that are 80% or higher in protein. We're talking about at least a concentrate, isolates. Whey protein isolates are going to be 90% protein. Now, the other thing you want to know is it a protein supplement or is it a meal replacer? Meal replacers are not protein supplements. Do you need meal replacers, yes or no? You don't need them. However, they are nice and convenient if you, again, need an economical option to go about your day. Now, the thing you want to know about meal replacer supplements is the macro split is going to be dramatically different from that of a protein supplement, and don't get it twisted. Don't get confused, and don't get manipulated by creative, clever marketing, because a meal replacer is significantly less protein, and therefore it should be significantly cheaper than a protein supplement. So for popular examples of this are Shakeology, BSN Synthesix, Muscle Gauge Nutrition's Gauge Lean Muscle Milk. Let me talk about Muscle Milk for a minute. Muscle Milk is essentially a glorified meal replacer. The powders. Now, if you're looking at the product, if the percentage of protein is 50% or less in a product, you guys, you got yourself a meal replacer. It's not a protein supplement. That means it already has a balanced amount of fat and carbs formulated into it. Now, there's nothing wrong with that. There's nothing bad about that. But don't buy a meal replacer product thinking it's a protein supplement. Like I said, carbs and fat are cheap. Protein is not. So if you want the convenience, like sometimes I'll grab a ready to drink from like a Wawa or a convenience store just because I'm traveling, I'm on the go, I need protein, and I'll grab something like that because I just didn't have anything on me. I will do that under those circumstances. But you guys, if you're buying the powders, I highly recommend get the highest amount of protein as possible, because once you start adding in blueberries, once you start adding in almond milk or coconut milk or whatever it is you put in your shake, if you mix it, anything in it, those macros are going to start adding up. So you're going to have the most leeway with your meal plan if you get yourself a very high protein supplement, low in carb, low in fat. All right, so the next thing you want to know about are weight gainers. Weight gainers are going to be primarily made up of carbohydrates. They will have little bit of protein in them, probably in the maybe 25%, maybe 30%. It's definitely 30% or under when it comes to protein content, but they're going to be really, they're going to have a lot of carbs in them. Sometimes the carbs will be from maltodextrin, sometimes the carbs will be from dextrose. These are short chain carbohydrates, simple sugars. They have a very high, they're like probably the highest on the like glycemic index scale, so they're going to go right into the bloodstream for an immediate source of energy. These are going to help you gain weight. And a lot of people aren't as apt to purchase weight gainers because people think to themselves, oh, well, if I'm trying to gain weight, I'll just eat more. And I urge you guys to reconsider weight gainers, actually, because if you are strategically trying to take in a significant amount of calories, this is specifically for my ectomorphs out there. I've had a lot of ectomorph clients on weight gainers, and it has tremendously helped them, because I've had some ladies like where like they literally need to be between 2,000 and 3,000 calories a day to reach their goals because they are just so underweight, and getting this many calories from food is just so much. And again, it's an economical, convenient option. So don't rule out weight gainer supplements. That's actually a place where I would encourage you to take a supplement, just because it's going to make sure that you're getting in the calories, because you can get like one shake 600 calories, and that sounds like a lot for those of you who are trying to shred or aren't really trying to do that, but it's a great way to get quality nutrition in that way. So another thing you want to consider when it comes to gaining weight is creatine monohydrate. It's going to help you build muscle. Now, without getting into a super detailed discussion on what creatine is, how it works, just know this. Creatine monohydrate is going to bloat you. The monohydrate has to do with the way the molecular structure is built, where it binds a water molecule, puts the water molecule into the muscle, giving you a more puffy or bloated look. However, it also makes your muscles look bigger. So, however, it does work from a scientific point of view. Creatine monohydrate is the most scientifically sound, researched supplement in the industry. Creatine is not a steroid. Creatine is actually naturally occurring in meat, so it is definitely not something that you should be afraid of. Just know that if you do take it, it is going to bloat you a little bit, but the bloating will go away once you're off of it. If you want to bypass the bloating effect and still get the muscle gain, weight gain benefit of creatine, go to a creatine ethyl ester or perhaps a creatine nitrate. These are bonded differently, and they do not have the water bloating effect. So creatine ethyl ester is definitely great for females. And these are the types of products that you can take like as a one-off. You can take them as capsules if you have that as a goal.